wife and I and Don Height and his wonderful wife, Joyce, who's not with us tonight, but is certainly here in spirit, would like to tell all of you how much you honor us by being here. My daughter is my everything. I can't believe earlier today that my wife and I gave her away. And with that said, my daughter, my great friend, my everything, has given me in return a fourth son. And that fourth son is Bradley. I love Bradley as if he was my own biological son. Broken, so
ashamed. For those that have known her for a short time, or for those who've known her whole life, all know that Elizabeth is truly one of a kind. It's her love for God and her love for others that really makes up her beauty. She's strong but gentle, committed to the truth, full of intelligent, Christ-like, and well-reasoned wisdom. You two are truly a force for the Lord. I'm so excited to see the amazing ways that you honor God through your marriage.
Brad is his authentic self. He's obviously a kind man, generous, the first one to lend a helping hand. My dad, who is here tonight, was a wonderful father to us. And our mom, who is not here physically tonight, you have said that she is your rock, and the love that mom had for you, you're going to have that wrapped around both of you for the rest of your life. I was sick, washed up and wasted. You took my bruises, I took your spirit.
Elizabeth, this day before God, I receive you into my life, that together we may be one.
Bradley, today before God and these friends, I take you to be my husband.
As Christ loves the church and gave himself for her, so I give myself for you.
You are the most important person in my life, and I will treasure you as a gift from God and an answer to prayer.
It is my privilege to be able to say that you are husband and wife, Bradley and Elizabeth. Bradley, you may kiss the bride.
Elizabeth and I we're just so good together. We laugh together. We talk. We love. We often like to say that we're teammates. God has been the author and perfecter of our relationship since the beginning. He really has. Most of you know that 5 days after I asked her to marry me, my mom passed away suddenly. In the weeks that followed, there was a funeral, obviously. Most of you who are here were there. And I don't remember much from the funeral. But what I do remember is this pillar of a woman who was standing next to me the whole time, who was just this strength, who was this edifying person in my life. And I just look forward to the years and the decades to come with you, because you're just the greatest gift I could ever have.
Marriage is a calling. I'm here to remind you that since the Lord's called you to this, He is going to supply everything that you need to fulfill your calling. It is Him that's called you, and He'll be faithful to complete. Right? You have His Spirit and you have His Word. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord God make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift His countenance upon you and give you peace. To Bradley and Elizabeth, God bless you and your marriage.
By your grace,